Toyota Tacoma is under attack by the Honda Ridgeline. Good morning, everybody. How are you today? Pretty good here. And that's right, the Toyota Tacoma is being attacked by the Honda Ridgeline. Of all trucks, the Honda Ridgeline. Now, we all know, of course, that the Tacoma is in the sights of every mid-sized truck manufacturer, right? I mean, the Ford Ranger, the Chevy Colorado, the Nissan Frontier to some degree. But the Honda Ridgeline, what am I talking about? Well, first of all, I was out nosing around on Honda's site the other night, just for kicks, because I do that, you know? I'm a YouTuber, and I've heard that Honda has kind of made the Ridgeline a little more truck-like. And I gotta say, they really have. It's really starting to look more like a truck than just an SUV with the bed on the back, right? Not looking too bad, especially that black edition. Yeah, I said it. I kind of dig the black edition. But anyway, I was nosing through, looking at the features and options and all that stuff, and I came to a section, and this is on Honda's website, where they are outwardly attacking the Toyota Tacoma, the TRD Sport specifically. They have a section on their website. You guys can check it out. Where they are comparing the Honda Ridgeline, and this is their sport trim level, directly to Toyota's Tacoma TRD Sport. Now, there were several areas that the Honda Ridgeline actually beats the Toyota Tacoma. I mean, what? Come on. And you know, this is a ding against Toyota, I think, because they are so reluctant and so slow to improve that it gives other manufacturers, even manufacturers like Honda, the ability or the opportunity to come in and challenge them, right? Toyota doesn't have to do this. They could adopt a philosophy where they at least improve the truck in areas that are competitively vulnerable, but they don't. So what am I talking about? Again, this is comparing the Honda Ridgeline Sport to the Tacoma TRD Sport. First of all, payload. Did you know that the Honda Ridgeline actually can haul more than that Toyota Tacoma? The payload on the Ridgeline is 1,596 pounds. On the TRD Sport, 1,100 pounds. I mean, 496 pounds, almost 500 pounds more? I mean, come on, man. 0 to 60. Now, this is a real kicker for me because if you watch the channel, then you know I love speed. Off the line speed, right? Acceleration. You know, I want to get up and go. And the Tacoma, it's not the quickest beast out there. It really isn't. The Honda Ridgeline has a 0 to 60 time of 6.1 seconds. 6.1 seconds. You know, that's getting down there into at least old time sports car category, right? I always said that if I was gonna buy a sports car, it had to have a sub 6 second 0 to 60 speed. The Ridgeline is this close, 6.1 seconds. What is the Tacoma TRD Sport? 7.4. That's a dog compared to the Ridgeline 6.1. What about the quarter mile? They threw in some other speeds, but we'll go with the quarter mile. The Ridgeline is 14.9 seconds at a speed, I guess, of 94 miles an hour, while the Toyota Tacoma is 15.7 seconds at a speed of 91 miles per hour. Again, besting the Toyota Tacoma. It's kind of embarrassing. You know, could you imagine you're sitting at a stoplight and, you know, you're feeling your oats, right? You decide you want to show that Ridgeline who's boss, right? So you're sitting there in your brand new 2021. And by the way, these specs are for the 2021 model year, so we're not going back in time. So you're sitting there at that stoplight. You got that weekend warrior in their Honda Ridgeline, right? You both kind of give that look, you know, because they know. They know they're faster than you are. So the light turns green, you stomp on it, and pew, the Ridgeline is gone. You've just been beaten by a Honda Ridgeline. Embarrassing. They did a dirt road slalom course, and I guess they measured the average speed of what the vehicle could get up to going through this course. The Ridgeline was 32 miles per hour, and the Toyota Tacoma was 31. Not a huge difference, but still, the king of off-road, right behind the Jeep, at least we think, got beaten by the Honda Ridgeline. The Honda Ridgeline! Some other features, and these are kind of, and I think these are some pretty cool features that the Ridgeline has. They have a lay-flat bed. In other words, there's no wheel wells in the way, right? You can slide a 4x8 sheet of plywood in there. It'll lay flat on the bed. Of course, in the Tacoma, you know, we can't do that because we have the wheel wells. Now, yeah, you can stick boards in and do all kinds of extra things to make it happen. But bottom line, you can't do it in the Tacoma, and you can in the Ridgeline. A dual action tailgate. This thing is pretty cool. What they mean by that is it opens up and down like a normal tailgate, right? But it also opens side to side, or at least from passenger side to driver side. It's a pretty cool little feature, and I know it's not a big deal. As long as you can open the tailgate, who cares? But it's just another example of the innovation that some of the other manufacturers are utilizing or employing, where Toyota, they just do the same thing, whatever. Lockable bed storage. Now, this is really cool. It's a trunk in the bed. If you're familiar with the Ridgeline, you've probably seen it. In the bed, you can open up a door, if you will, and there is storage down below that you can lock. So not only do you get the bed, you also get a trunk. You don't have to have a tonneau cover. You can put a tonneau cover on the Ridgeline, but you don't have to have it. You can store things securely in the bed. Of course, we know the Tacoma does not have that. More passenger space. Now, I saw pictures and stuff, and I think one of the big complaints about the Tacoma is the room inside. It really feels kind of confining, particularly in the back. I gotta tell you, in looking at the Honda Ridgeline, it's almost cavernous back there as compared to the Toyota Tacoma. Now, it's not Toyota Tundra cavernous. I mean, the Tundra, you know, the Crewmax is huge. But there's a heck of a lot more room in the Honda Ridgeline than there is in the Toyota Tacoma. It's very disheartening when I see stuff like this, because again, I think Toyota, they have the number one selling truck out there, man. I mean, what are you doing when you let people creep in like the Honda Ridgeline? And don't get me wrong, I'm not a Honda Ridgeline hater. I thought about getting one once. I'll admit it, I did. But I just couldn't get over the body style. That was the biggest thing for me. The look of the truck. It just didn't look right. It didn't really look like a truck to me. But they're rectifying that. They have changed the design, and it is more truck looking than it has ever been. Now, I know a lot of people out there are going to complain about its unibody, its suspension, the way it handles the off-road stuff, right? But let's face it. 96% of the people that own four-wheel drive vehicles never go off-road. So is that really a good argument? I don't know. Anyway, leave a comment. Let me know what you think. What's going on? Are you happy that the Ridgeline is encroaching on the Toyota Tacoma, that it's even beating it in some areas, and that Toyota seemingly is doing nothing about it? I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, check out my other channel. I actually have two other channels. The first is RobMotive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. My second is RobMotive Civic, and it's all about my experiences with the Honda Civic Sport Hatch and the Honda Civic Type R. Check those out if you would. Subscribe if you like them. Also, don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.